In this demonstration, we're going to learn how to do the pop effect in Adobe After Effects. Let's go ahead and start with a new composition. And so I'll go ahead and make that a black composition so it's empty. And we want to start off with a layer. So I'll go up to my layers and say new solid layer. And I've already gotten my settings set up to be sort of a teal color, so we'll use that. The next thing I want to do is make my object that I want to have the pop effect occur on. And so I'll just go ahead and make an ellipse. And so I'll drag out that ellipse to about the size I want it to be when it's finished up. And then I want to make sure that that center point is in the center. So if you'll notice, when I click off and click on the ellipse, the axis point is right here. So if we hold down Command and double click this panned behind tool, that'll center it. Or if you have a full-size keyboard and you're on a Mac, you can hit Command Option Home or Control Alt Home, and that will center that axis point as well. Once we've done that, we can come into our align settings. Our align settings are set to composition. If you don't see the align settings, you can find them under Window, and just click center and center. That'll place it where we want it. And next thing I want to do is just double check and make sure my composition is appropriate length. So this is a 2 second composition at 30 frames per second. And so let's go ahead and, I'm sorry, it's at 24 frames per second. So 24 frames per second, 2 seconds long. And what we want to do is just go ahead and animate that scale effect happening. And so I'll come in and select my shape layer. And all I want to see is the scale, so I'll hit S on my keyboard to show the scale effect. And what I'll do is come in and keyframe it where I want it to be at its largest, or at its standard size where it finishes up. So I like to sort of keyframe backwards. So I'm going to have the effect start around here and end around here. So I'm going to go ahead and go to the end and do my stopwatch effect. So just click that stopwatch button so we've got a keyframe. I'm going to go a couple of spaces in or back, maybe just one. And here's where I'll go ahead and scale it up, right? So I'll scale this up so it's bigger than my screen, and you can see it made a keyframe for me. And then I'll go maybe a few frames in, and I'm going to go to 0. On my scale. So it's effectively disappeared because the scale of that object is 0. And so what we've got right now is it going from 0 to a little bigger than we wanted and then smaller. And that is really the essence of that pop effect. So we're getting the effect right now, but it feels a little not quite right. So there's a couple things I would do. I would select all these keyframes on the scale, right click on them and say keyframe assistant, easy ease, or it's F9 on your keyboard. And that right away will make a nice little difference, so it feels better when it pops out. So we're seeing that pop effect. And then last but not least, I think turning on your motion blur is a really important thing to add in there. So motion blur is activated right here, and I turned it on the layer using this little button right there. And so that is the pop effect. Thank you very much for watching.